I'm Jen Schiffer, and I work at Fog Creek as the community engineer on Glitch.com. Glitch is the friendly community where you'll build the app of your dreams, and we want to introduce you to different ways to build those apps. In this video series, we're going to talk about React. React is a user interface or UI framework that came from the engineers at Facebook and is very popular right now. There's many different ways to build apps, and React is one of them. In this video series, we're going to introduce you to some engineers from here in New York City who are using React every day in their job. And I'm going to go over some example apps that I've created on Glitch.com that you can remix and build with React. So Glitch is a friendly community where you'll build the app of your dreams. And what does that actually mean? Glitch provides you an in-browser editor where you can write all sorts of code. Here we have some HTML, JavaScript, CSS, and every time you make a change, it auto-deploys, so you don't have to worry about DevOps stuff. When you go to glitch.com, you'll see that there's a wide array of apps already created by the community and us for you to use. You can view the source of them, you can remix them, and we've separated them by categories that make them easier to find. For example, if you're new to coding, we have cool tutorial apps for you to learn to code. I've made three example apps in Glitch that use React. The first of which is Starter React, which just has React as a dependency. And then I've remixed that to create Starter React Router. React Router is a library for React that allows you to manage routes and URLs on the client side. And then I've created Starter React Redux. Redux is a way to manage state in JavaScript applications.
React is a view library that allows you to create and manage the user interface of your web application. You would use React where you start to notice that your application is dealing with a lot of data and a lot of your UI components are dynamically changing a lot based on things like user interactions and also fresh data that's grabbed from the server.
I think React highlights a lot of the native browser features that we have, so React still uses normal HTML elements, CSS and stuff. And I think that's what made it really popular in the community. It also challenges a lot of the best practices that we've had for a long time with, for example, adding HTML with JavaScript is something that was completely new when React came out, and I think that surprised a lot of people. And another thing is it also was probably one of the fastest UI tools out there to build really complex things, and it made it a lot easier to build them. So
my experience with building React apps with new developers is that React guides you towards doing the right thing, whereas a lot of other frameworks of that time were, you had to sort of fight against your instincts.
React probably has one of the best documentation out there. It has a huge community that's backing it. It has a lot of contributors that's contributing every day, making pull requests and issues and stuff. So I think, React has one of the most vibrant communities out there.
So you might want to choose React over other frameworks because if you want to have more control about how you arrange the different pieces, and you might want different configuration, or you just want something that's slightly less opinionated than some of the other heavier frameworks out there.
In this video, we learned about what React is and why you might use it. And in the next video, we're going to actually use it in an app and learn more about the programming concepts that it introduces.